Here we go again for another thrilling episode of Proof of God, where I try to prove to you that there really is an entity on earth with us that's trying to communicate with people, but nobody pays attention. All right? The being is telepathic, and it can control the environment and stuff like that. Like, it actually truly shapes the clouds into signs in response to questions as a way of trying to communicate with people to prove that the being actually exists. But anyway, I'm going to try to prove it to you right now. So here we go. Dear best friend God, I've had enough. I can't tolerate the retarded Canadians anymore. I found a book called The Dictionary, and it's disturbing me. The Canadian government mandated the sexualization of all children by demanding the right to instruct children about homosexuality and teaching them to be accepting of retarded faggots. It is well known that children are not sexual until they have been exposed to sexuality. Therefore, it can be said that Canadians are interfering with the natural development of children. That is called molesting, because molest means to bother, interfere with, or annoy. Basically, the Canadians think molesting children is acceptable. There is a word called good, which means that which is desirable and or acceptable. And so it can be said that Canadians demand the right to molest children because they believe it is good. I think everyone with a brain would agree that demonstrates that Canadians lack good instincts, and that means they are mentally defective / handicapped. It also means that they are highly objectionable and offensive, which is what the word obnoxious means. The word creep means an obnoxious, deviant, and painfully introverted person, or painfully introverted person. And so it can be said that Canadians are mentally retarded creeps. The Canadians are freaks, God. If it's true that Canadians are severely retarded creeps that believe they have a right to molest all the children because they think it's good, then create a face, the word hi, and a heart in the clouds. Now, this is where we try to prove that the being is actually watching and listening to me, because I'll go outside, and with any luck, if the being is here today, it will have shaped the clouds into a face, the word hi, and a heart. So let's get this thing focused. All right, now let's see. Let's try to film the clouds, and we'll look for a face, a heart, and the word hi. A face, a heart, and the word hi. I can't hardly see anything because the sun's so bright, but I'm gonna try to film the sky blindly, and then I'll go in and check the video to see if it showed up. But I can't see anything right now because the sun is so bright and there's reflections all over the screen. But we're looking for the word hi, hi, and a heart, hi, and a heart, and a face. There's a place I like to go. Alright. So I'm gonna go inside now, and we'll see if the word hi showed up, a face, and a heart. Alright, we'll film for another few seconds here. All right, so there we go.